TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 6th of January. Delhi police probing attack on students in JNU campus, says official. Thousands protest in Pakistan over US killing of Iranian commander. An Afghan president issues decrees to curb air pollution in Kabul. And now for all the details. A day after violence broke out at Jawaharlal Nehru University premises in India's capital, New Delhi, as masked men armed with sticks and rods attacked students and teachers, the varsity saw a heavy security in place on Monday. Meanwhile, a senior police official said the police is probing the incident amid backlash over failing to protect students.
Jawaharlal Nehru University in India's capital New Delhi on Monday saw a heavy security in place a day after violence broke out at the varsity premises as masked men armed with sticks and rods attacked students and teachers and damaged property on the campus. Clashes broke out late on Sunday between JNU students who were protesting against a fee hike and young wing members of Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad or ABVP, a group closely tied to India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party. Students across India on Monday staged protests condemning the violence in JNU. They expressed their solidarity with the JNU students. A senior police official said that police are investigating the incident.
यहाँ तक सवाल है identification का कि दोनों side से जो झगड़ा हुआ है कि कौन-कौन उसमें participate कर रहा था उस चीज के लिए all possible methods जो हैं investigation के वो invoke किए जा रहे हैं हम social media में जो videos circulate हो रहे हैं जो messages circulate हो रहे हैं उनको भी देख रहे हैं और बिल्कुल right earnest में investigation चल रही है और जल्दी ही identification कर ली जाएगी.
Meanwhile, Chief Proctor of the University, Dhananjay Singh, said that efforts are on to normalize the situation in the campus after JNU authorities met with the Secretary of Ministry of Human Resource Development on Monday.
We are truly very much concerned. That's why we came to the MHRD and we had a very positive interaction with the Honorable Secretary and all efforts are being made to normalize the situation in the university campus.
While as several opposition leaders condemn the violence and student protests across the country continue, the JNU Teachers Association have demanded the removal of Vice Chancellor M. Jagdish Kumar after the attack on students and faculty members.
India's Foreign Ministry on Sunday condemned the targeted killing of 25-year-old man belonging to the minority Sikh community in Pakistan's Peshawar city and urged the neighboring country to take immediate action. The incident came 2 days after a mob attacked the holy site in Pakistan where Sikhism's founder Guru Nanak was born and raised anti-Sikh slogans.
India's Foreign Ministry on Sunday said that India strongly condemns the targeted killing of a 25-year-old man from the minority Sikh community in Pakistan's Peshawar that follows the recent despicable vandalism and desecration of Gurdwara Nankana Sahib and the unresolved case of abduction, forced conversion and marriage of a Sikh girl. The young Pakistani Sikh, identified as Parvinder Singh, had returned to the country from abroad recently for his wedding. He was killed late Saturday evening by unknown gunmen in Peshawar. Parvinder's brother, Harmeet Singh, who is known as Pakistan's first Sikh news anchor, blamed the government for failing to provide security to the handful of minority families left in Pakistan.
Because today, the blood that I have to take, tomorrow, my own Sikh brothers, Hindu brothers, Christian brothers, they will have to take. तो अकलियतों का डंडोरा तो आप पीटते हैं पूरी दुनिया में अकलियतें महफूज है लेकिन ये है कि हम हर साल में हमें लाशें उठानी पड़ती है.
The incident came after a mob attacked Gurdwara Nankana Sahib the birthplace of Sikhism's founder Guru Nanak in Pakistan's Punjab province on Friday. The mob was seen spewing anti-Sikh slurs outside the Sikh holy site. The main culprit who incited the mob was reportedly arrested on Sunday following a huge public outcry against the Pakistani government for failing to take action in the matter.
Moving on, hundreds of people in Pakistan carried an anti-US protest rally on Sunday over the killing of Iranian commander Qasem Soleimani. The angry protesters chanted slogans against the United States as Soleimani, the architect of Iran's spreading military influence in the Middle East, was killed in a US-led drone strike last week.
Hundreds of people carried out a protest on Sunday in Pakistan's Karachi city and clashed with police over killing of powerful Iranian commander Qasem Soleimani in a US drone strike last week in Iraq. Clashes in the city erupted when the demonstrators on Sunday tried to force their way towards the tightly guarded US consulate while protesting. The protesters, including children, chanted slogans of death to America and death to Israel, and many held photographs of Soleimani and burnt mock US and Israeli flags.
پاکستان کی زمین پڑوسی اسلامی ملک کے خلاف اگر استعمال ہوئی تو پاکستان کا سنی اور شیعہ اس موقع پر ایسی موقع پر گھر میں نہیں بیٹھے گا بلکہ ہم اپنے احتجاج کو اس حد تک لے جائیں گے کہ ہم پاکستان میں کم از کم امریکی مفادات کو نقصان پہنچانے کی صلاحیت رکھتے ہیں
Meanwhile, a similar rally was held in Pakistani capital Islamabad, where protesters dragged US and Israeli flags along streets before burning them. Soleimani was the architect of Iran's spreading military influence in the Middle East. The Pentagon said the strike was aimed at deterring future Iranian attack plans. Iran, with a Shiite Muslim majority, enjoys a large support base in Pakistan, its neighbor to the east. Though Pakistan is a Sunni Muslim majority country, it has a fairly large Shiite population.
In news from Afghanistan, air pollution in Afghan capital Kabul continues to be harmful and has worsened with the arrival of winter, threatening the lives of residents. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani over the weekend signed two orders to reduce air pollution in Kabul, one of the most polluted cities globally.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani over the weekend signed two orders to reduce air pollution in capital Kabul, one of the most polluted cities globally, the presidential palace said in a statement. The orders are: one, requiring smoke purifiers for heating systems in residential, business and government buildings, and another banning the burning of rubber and plastic. Despite recent snowfall, Kabul is still among the top 10 cities with the most polluted air, according to an international air quality monitoring organization, Air Visual. According to the Ministry of Public Health, at least 17 people died of respiratory infections and related health conditions last month. Meanwhile, in a bid to curb pollution, the National Environment Protection Agency, or NEPA, said that over 60 businesses, including 33 brickyards, were closed in the Urghani area and west of Kabul on Sunday.
In news from Nepal, Nepal police on Sunday released 122 Chinese nationals on bail who were arrested over alleged involvement in cyber fraud and for defying immigration law. Incidents of crimes involving Chinese nationals have significantly gone up in recent times in Nepal.
Nepal police on Sunday released 122 Chinese nationals on bail who were detained last month for their alleged involvement in cyber fraud and for defying the immigration law. The District Administration Office in capital Kathmandu released the Chinese nationals on bail of ₹1,000 each due to lack of evidence, local media reported. The Chinese nationals will now be deported to China by two Chinese regular flights within 2 days, reports suggested. Police had confiscated hundreds of laptops, desktop computers, mobile phones and SIM cards from the detained Chinese nationals during raids at various places in Kathmandu. Incidents of crime, including cyber heist, rape and human trafficking involving Chinese nationals, have significantly gone up in recent times in Nepal. Earlier in September, police had arrested five Chinese nationals on a charge of stealing money by hacking bank cash machines. Chinese citizens were also arrested with smuggled gold this year in the Himalayan nation.
An elephant breeding and training center in Soraha in southern Nepal has been drawing a lot of domestic as well as foreign tourists. Elephants and calves can be seen getting pampered at the center, which is one of the biggest training centers for tuskers in the world.
Playing in mud, bathing with showers, feasting on specially prepared fodder and getting pampered is basically how a normal day pans out for elephants at a famous breeding and training center for them in southern Nepal's small village of Soraha. A dedicated team of mahouts looks after the tuskers at the center for elephants in Soraha, which is about 3 kilometers outside the Chitwan National Park, Nepal's most important conservation area and a lucrative tourist destination. The elephant breeding and training center has also been drawing a lot of domestic as well as foreign tourists.
Nikai ramailo lagyo yo thau ma aisakda ra hamile jun euta apeksha lieko thiyau tyo aaja hamro pura bhayeko cha yaha aisake pachhari ra estai garda kheri yaha hamile bibhinna hati haru ka sana bachcha haru thula haru dekhdai garda kheri ra yaha chai hamro student haru ma pani ke euta utsukta jayo bhanda kheri hami hati safari kina najane bhanne kura haru pani bhayo ra jasle garda chai yaha ko euta jibiko parjan ko rup ma pani euta mahatwapurna bhumika khelna sakne hami dekheka chhau jastai yaha ka homestay haru yaha bata chai hami jungle safari jane kram haru ma yaha bata nikai dherai labh chai yo kshetra le lina.
With dozens of breeding elephants and calves, it is one of the biggest elephant training centers in the world. They are often exchanged for rhinos from Myanmar and Thailand, and sometimes with elephants of India as well, to keep the breeds mixed.
The 12-day-long River Fair Dwijing Festival is grabbing eyeballs in India's northeastern Assam province, with hundreds of tourists thronging the banks of River Ai to take part in the New Year festivities. The festival is an annual affair which features adventure sports and gives tourists a first-hand experience of Assam's ethnic culture and cuisine.
Annual River Fair, locally called the Dwijing Festival, has been attracting visitors on the bank of River Ai in India's northeastern Assam province with gaiety. Scores of tourists are thronging a 12-day event which is featuring a number of activities like adventure sports and elephant rides and is giving visitors first-hand experience of Assam's culture and cuisine. Dwijing Festival is celebrated every year with various cultural programs to make it a center of attraction for the visitors as a New Year festival.
यहाँ पे हर कोई मौज मस्ती एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स कल्चर म्यूजिक सब मिलेंगे आप लोग को.
With the target of promoting river tourism in Assam, the festival was initiated in 2016 under the name Ai River Winter Festival, which later changed to Dwijing, meaning river bank. The event was scheduled to conclude on January 7.
Thousands of followers of Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama from across the globe attended his teaching session in India's eastern Bodh Gaya city on Sunday. Dalai Lama held the Manjushri cycle of teachings, which is unique to the Gelug lineage of Buddhism.
Thousands of followers of Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama from across the globe attended his teaching session in India's eastern Bodh Gaya city on Sunday. As part of the three-day teachings of the Manjushri cycle of teachings, the Dalai Lama gave the permission of a deity called Jetsunma Nakmo. The Manjushri cycle of teachings is unique to the Gelug lineage of Buddhism and it includes Guru Yoga, the solitary hero Manjushri sadhana, blessings and so forth. While he undertook the preparatory procedures, Dalai Lama asked the devotees to recite the 21 praises to Tara.
I'm very happy to be here. It's my first time in India, and well, these days the Dalai Lama teachings are very beautiful. The energy here is incredible, and I never feel one sensation like this. So I'm so happy to share all of these things and this energy with everybody.
The ongoing session is part of Dalai Lama's 5-day long Kal Chakra or Wheel of Time teaching session that began on January 2nd and will conclude on January 6th.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.